Hey, good morning everyone. Today we are here with the new English book, which is your course book, New Pathways, right? And from this book, we are going to start our first unit, that is Growing Up, okay? In which we are going to see two chapters, two story and a poem, okay? So today we are here with the first means unit, and we'll see the section first from this unit. Before that, a starter is given here. Ask your parents, grandparents, or any elders in your family to tell you a funny incident from their childhood. Or when they or a friend, classmate, got into trouble at home or in school. Means you have to ask to your parents or grandparents or any elders that they have done some funny incident in their school or in home. Okay. They may be their friends or as classmate. Okay, you have to ask this to your elders. Then after getting the information, what you have to do is, again you have to ask something to them, that how do you think they would react if you were to the same thing or got into a similar situation at school. Means first you have to get the information, after that you have to ask that what if I'll do, means I'll repeat the same thing, what gonna be their reaction. Okay, you have to ask it. Okay, so here the section 1 from this unit, Growing Up. How Daddy Played Ping Pong. Okay, now read a story about a schoolboy obsessed with ping pong. Obsessed means which is very attracted towards a thing, thinking and talking about the means only thinking and about talking about the thing. Okay, so here is a boy who is telling a means a childhood story of his father. When Daddy was a little schoolboy, a new game was invented. When my daddy was a schoolboy, at that time a game was invented. It was called ping pong. It was called ping pong. Nowadays, lot of children play ping pong. But in those days, ping pong was all the rage. Means it was quite popular. It was played from morning till night in every school and courtyard, on tables, benches, grand pianos, and on the floor. Some even played at night also. Many kids forgot that anything else existed except this ping pong. Means many children were like very attracted towards this ping pong. They forgot everything that anything existed rather than this ping pong. They were only excited, only means indulged this playing this ping pong. They were ping pong matches in little daddy's school every single day. Means every single day they had the match of ping pong. Every class played each other to determine the school champion. Means all were playing in such a way that they could determine the school champion. Then they played each other and the winner became the district champion. Means every single day they were playing the ping pong, and at the they played each other and winner became the district champion. Then there was a city tournament. Then Moscow and Leningrad played each other. Little Daddy was amazed. He just couldn't understand why it was so interesting to keep bouncing a little white ball back and forth with little paddles. Means back and forth means from one place to another and back again, hitting the ball. Why don't you try it? One of his friend would say. Means little daddy friend would say always that, come and join and play with us. But my little daddy, it's no fun. His friend used to say that, it is, come and play. But my little daddy kept saying that, no it is not. Just try it once. I don't want to. This conversation was repeated several times. But naturally, one bright day, little daddy got a ping pong paddle and took his place at one side of the table. Now, one bright day came when the little daddy took interested and joined his friend to the other side of the table. And that was the end of him. I say one bright day, but little daddy's parents considered it to be one of the darkest day of their lives. And all because little daddy became fascinated by ping pong. Yes, because little daddy got interested, he got fascinated by ping pong game. In the beginning, he couldn't manage to hit the ball, but finally he learned to hit the ball. It wouldn't bounce on the table. At last, when little daddy managed to hit the ball and it bounced across the table, he took a real interest in the game. Earlier, he wasn't interested to this game, but later on, he got interested towards this game. He discovered that there were different ways of hitting the ball. Means, as he got interested, he kept on taking interest to this game, ping pong game. He discovered many of the ways of hitting the ball. He could chop it. He could send it into a spin, off to one of the corners, etc. A good player could make the ball bounce on the part of his opponent's side of the table. That was the hardest to reach. My daddy knows how to play the ping pong ball, but it was the hardest thing that to make the ball bounce on the part of his opponent's side of the table. That was the hardest to reach. Daddy still think ping pong is a wonderful game, but back then little daddy thought it was the most fascinating game in the world. Earlier he was not interested, he took interest in that later on he realized that it is the most fascinating, most popular game in the world, in which he took interest. He gave up reading, he stopped doing his homework. The only reason he went to school at all was to play his favorite game. As you know, the game was played every single day in his school. And due to that, he went to school. He gave up reading also. He stopped doing his homework. And that is the reason his marks kept getting worse and worse. He began playing better and better, but his marks kept getting worse and worse. The teacher took him aside and talked to him several times. She explained that there was a limit to everything. She even reminded him of saying, "There's time for everything." Means, as the possible way, the teacher tried to explain him that there must be some limit for everything and there must be a time for everything. But my little daddy was not ready to listen anyone. Little daddy didn't argue because it was no use. He knows that nobody could understand his obsession for the ping pong game. Nobody can. How could he make her understand that ping pong was the work of his life while everything else was play? He became so good at the game that he could beat many of his friends. The day he beat the school's third best player, his teacher said, "I want to speak to your parents. Things cannot continue as they are now." Means he became so good that he could beat his school student, even the third best player of the school. But the teacher was not happy with this. She told that this can't continue like this. I must have to talk with your parents. She wrote a letter to grandpa and grandma, which they never received, because little daddy pulled it out of the mailbox, read it and tore it up. It was so awful that he tore it up into tiny bits. Means the letter was written so bad, so embarrassing one, that he took out the letter from the mailbox and tore it up in small bits. His teacher sent his parent another letter. It was still worse than the first one. So little daddy did the same thing, but now he tore the letter even into tinier bits. I am ashamed to say so, but that's actually happened. Little daddy's teacher was very surprised, for grandpa and grandma never came to see her. Just as she was about to write them a third letter, little daddy beat the school champion at ping pong. After that, he decided there was no use going to school anymore, and so he didn't. Every morning he would make believe that he was going to school, but there were no notebooks or textbook in his school bag. Instead, there were two ping pong paddles, a net and three balls, and a sandwich, which was little daddy's lunch. Means he was just pretending that he was going to attend the school, but instead of that he was not attending the school, he bunks. And in his bag there were no notebooks, no textbook, and instead of that he had two paddles, three balls and a net, and even a sandwich, which was little daddy's lunch. All day long he played ping pong. Little daddy had many new friends, all of whom were equally crazy about ping pong. Means now the little daddy got new friends who were equally mad about the ping pong. He knew every Moscow champion by sight. The famous Falkovich brothers greeted him as an equal. He became a member of the junior team. He would already lost his first real game. At this point, his teacher, having received no answer to her letter and missing little daddy in class, went to see him. Now the thing got changed. Earlier, when the letter was written to the grandpa and grandma, that was torn by the daddy. And now he is not attending the school. He is just bunking the school and going to play. Long day he used to play ping pong, and even he had new friends who were equally mad about this ping pong. Now the teacher got worried when she noticed that little daddy was absent, regular absent, and even his parents are also not coming to the school to meet. Now she decided to go and meet his parent. Little daddy was not at home. Grandma and grandpa were though. When they discovered their son had been playing hooky. What is this hooky? To avoid or skip school or work without permission. Means now the little daddy started to doing the work without permission. Means without the information, he bunked the school and went on playing the ping pong. And was spending his day slamming a little white ball around. They were thunderstruck. Means they were shocked by listening this. They decided that little daddy was out of his mind. Means they thought that my son had gone out of his mind. After all, they would never play ping pong. They hid these paddles and balls and took little daddy to a doctor. They thought that my son has lost his mind. They thought of take his son to the doctor. This was no plain ordinary doctor. This was a professor who had spent his life treating crazy people. Means what do you think? Daddy was crazy? No, he was not crazy. He was obsessed with the ping pong game. However, he would never play ping pong. He simply couldn't understand why little daddy had to play hooky on account of this game called ping pong. Little daddy couldn't understand why the professor was asking him such stupid question. Okay, so later we'll discuss about the chapter. Now you have to just read the chapter carefully, okay? So go through the chapters and go through the video properly and understand the chapter, okay? Rest of the chapter we'll discuss it tomorrow.